But if you go back to Psalms 31 and 5, Psalms 31 and 5, if you read the whole verse, the whole chapter of Psalms 31, you will find that is a psalm of victory. Because it is a psalm where David, who was going through, who was on the run from Saul, who had enemies all around him, who was going through a dark time in his own life, and basically quoted the same verse, that even though that I'm going through, even though there's situations in my life, but because I'm trusting in God. Because the Lord, he said, is my strength. God is on the throne.
Amen.
The Lord, even though I'm going to have to go through some things, but I know that the Lord is on my side. See, what you got to understand is this here, is that Jesus is just taking what he heard, what was in the Bible already, and he is just using it and quoting it to let you know that even though I'm in a dark situation, and even though it may look like that I'm down, but he's also turning around and saying, but I'm not out of this yet. See, what you got to realize, saints of God, as we read, many of us in here have also gone through a very similar death experience.
Amen.
There are many of us here, I heard one of the speakers said that the scripture said to take up your cross and follow me. Many times, saints of God, many of us have found ourselves in a very humiliating situation. I heard a person talk about how they said about the crucifixion, how it was one of the most humiliating situations a person could ever go in.
Amen.
If you want to find out how to punish somebody, how to humiliate somebody, but also to make a statement that if you break the law, this is what's going to happen. But see, the Lord is saying tonight to us, he's saying is that if you give yourself over to me, in other words, trust me with yourself, trust me with your money, trust me with your life, trust me with your body, trust me with your heart, trust me with the things that are dear unto you. And he's letting you know is that if you trust me, if you trust me initially with what you have, he said, I'll also see you through and bring you into a place of glory, into a place of greatness, and into a place of empowerment. If you realize, saints of God, when he said you, the message is simply, Lord, you can have all of me. I want you to realize, saints, that God is telling you even in his word. He said that he will keep that which you commit unto him. Is there anyone in this room who has their mind made up that I'm ready to commit everything over to God? Because you can't really say that I'm a soldier. In the army of the Lord, I'm marching for God, I'm living for God, and I'm living, and I'm one foot in the church and one foot out the door. We've got to make up our mind and say, Lord, I'm going to be in either out the door, or I'm going to be in the house of God. We've got to say, Lord, make me ready. Lord, I want to be spirit-filled. Lord, I want to be one of those that's caught up in the number. God, I want to be one of those. Tired of playing the church games that we play all the time? Aren't you tired of doing all of these things? We tithe and we run and we give and we play the instruments, we preach the word, we do all these things. But why do them if you're not going to get anything out of it? Why do them if we're not going to dedicate? Why do them if we're not going to put our all behind what we say? Why do it if we're not going to back up our word with action? Why do it if we're not going, if we're only going to be hearers of God's word and not doers of what he's saying? He said, Lord, you can have all of me. Because see, saints of God, God don't want a third of you. He doesn't want half of us. But he said,